The Japan Society, or Japan America Society of Hawaii, has been serving as a bridge between Japan, Asia, and Hawaii for generations. I've been through the program, my mom has, but now the next generation of JASH ambassadors are here, and I'm surrounded by these great little kids. They're so cute. Real quickly, though, before we go, can we go ahead and introduce yourself? First of all, what's your name?
I'm Luke, and I go to New Valley.
Excellent. And your name?
Chloe.
And where are you going?
And I go to Sacred Heart.
Nice. And I'm going to kind of squeeze on over here. What's your name, buddy?
I'm Landon, and I go to Monolo Elementary School.
Okay, and in the back row here?
My name is Landon. I go to Marino.
Oh, two Landons. Okay, and real quickly, sweetie, kind of squeeze on over here because you're so cute. What's your name?
My name is Tierra, and I go to Pearl Ridge Elementary School.
Awesome, Pearl Ridge, the Pearl Ridge side. And last but not least, what's your name?
My name is Gia, and I go to University Laboratory School.
Awesome. Now, these are the ambassadors of JASH. They're going to be heading to Japan really soon, right around the corner. I got to ask, are you excited to go to Japan?
Yes, I'm very excited.
What are you excited about? There's so many cool things, and I don't want to put you on the spot, but what's something you're looking forward to go check out?
I'm learning to see the difference between Japan and Hawaii.
Wow. Now, has anybody you guys been to Japan before? Who's been to Japan before? Raise your hands. Ah, so new experience for you guys. Are you guys excited as well?
Yes.
Yeah. Awesome. Now, they're actually going to be getting ready to do a little bit of a showcase in a bit, but Trini, you have a little bit more on the program over there, right?
Mm-hmm, thank you so much, Taizo. I am here with Lenny Yajima, who is the president of the Japan America Society of Hawaii. Thank you for being with us.
Trini, thank you.
So tell us about this convention that the kids are going to be participating in.
Well, the APCC is now in its 27th year of serving the Asia Pacific region, and it brings together over 200 students from about 45 countries. And for a global youth camp, and the children learn about the similarities and differences, you know, between their countries, and it's just a really wonderful life-changing experience.
What
for
an
all these
incredible
kids.
Opportunity!
And we
really?
Are so fortunate. Japan America Society is so honored to be able to choose and train the students, and we've done that for 13 years now.
Let's talk about the training. What kind of training do you provide the delegates?
The training for the cultural part of the program is a chant that they learn. It's an oli mahalo, so to show gratitude for everything in life, and also a hula. They'll be performing Ka'uluwehi Oke Kai, and you'll get to see that this morning. And we also train them on basic Japanese etiquette. And another really neat thing is they have homework assignments, and they learn about the different countries where they'll be interacting, you know, with students from those countries. And I've got to tell you something really special about
yes.
this group. When the great earthquake hit in Nepal, on their own, they decided they wanted to do something for the, you know, the children of Nepal. And together they raised $415 from, you know, from can recycling and piggy banks broken. And I don't know if they would have known to do that if it hadn't been for the training that they received
sure.
about, you know, social responsibility. So,
well, these are obviously yeah. some exceptional children that you have here. How are they selected? I'm sure a lot of kids want to go to Japan.
Yes, it's a stringent process, and it's an interview, and we have a selection committee that chooses them based on, you know, their leadership skills and their teamwork skills.
Tell me a little bit about the history of this convention. How did it start, and how has it evolved?
Over 27 years. You know, the actual history, I'm still new to the society,
okay.
so I'm not quite familiar with the
yeah.
actual history. I just know that it's a great program that we are honored to administer.
Well, let me ask you this. How can people who want to help this convention, this program, how can they get involved?
Well, if they could help by joining the Japan America Society of Hawaii, we have many educational programs, and this is one of the main ones that we administer, but we do have operating expenses too, so our membership
yes.
is very nominal, $50 for general membership or $75 for family membership, and that helps us put on the other programs that we provide the community. We have Japan in a Suitcase, Japan Wizards Competition, and Japan Day. So if they could, if our public could support Japan America Society, that would be wonderful.
Yes. Now, this is very, very exciting to have students travel to Japan every summer. So if children who are thinking ahead for next year, how can they sign up or how can they get more information?
We will have applications available on our website starting in December, and the interviews will start in January. And so if they go to www.jashhawaii.org they can find an application there in advance December.
But you have to be 11 years old.
Yes,
right?
you have to be 11 years old.
That's the magic number. My daughter's 10, so we're going to be trying for this next year. All right, well, thank you so
much.
This is very exciting. You mentioned Ka'uluwehi o Ke Kai.
Yes.
So we are going to have these gorgeous kids perform for us in just a moment. But first, coming up after the break, we are going to wrap things up and tell you what we have in store for you tomorrow when Living 808 returns. All right, kids, take it away.